Diabetes is a condition that develops because of elevated levels of glucose or blood sugar in the bloodstream. Many people with diabetes take insulin every day to help keep their blood sugar at a normal, healthy level. There are many ways to take insulin, such as with a syringe, pen, or pump. This video will review how to draw up and give an injection of insulin using a syringe. There are many types of insulin. Many people take two types of insulin. One is long-acting, the other is rapid-acting. Your doctor will tell you what kind of insulin to take, how much to take, and when to take it. Most people with diabetes take insulin with meals and at bedtime. Insulin will spoil if it gets too hot or too cold. You need to store it properly in order for it to keep working. Keep insulin at a temperature between 36 degrees Fahrenheit to 86 degrees Fahrenheit. In most cases, that means you can leave opened bottles at room temperature. Most insulin lasts 28 days after opening. Put a date on the bottle to remind you when to throw it away. Keep unopened bottles in the refrigerator, and the insulin will stay good through the expiration date on the label. Learning to draw up insulin from the bottle takes practice. Your nurse and a diabetes educator will help you learn. To draw up insulin, use a clean, flat surface to place your insulin, syringe, and other supplies. Wash your hands with soap and water. Check the label to make sure the insulin has not spoiled, expired, or been opened longer than 28 days. Wipe the top of the insulin bottle with alcohol swab. Remove the cap from the needle. Pull back the syringe's plunger to the number of units of insulin you'll be taking. This will pull air into the syringe. Push the needle through the rubber top of the insulin bottle while it is on the flat surface. Push the plunger all the way down to push the air in the syringe into the bottle. This makes it easier to draw out the insulin. Keep the needle in the bottle and turn the bottle upside down. Draw up the dose of insulin you need. You may see air bubbles in the syringe. To remove air bubbles, push all the insulin back into the bottle and draw up the dose again. You can also tap the top of the syringe to make the bubbles rise to the top. Push the bubbles back into the bottle. If needed, pull back on the plunger again until you have the correct amount of insulin in the syringe. Having bubbles in the syringe will not harm you. However, bubbles take the place of insulin, so you will not be getting the full amount you need. Once the bubbles are removed, take the needle out of the bottle when you have the correct dose of insulin. Once you have the right amount of insulin in the syringe, have another person check that you drew up the right dosage. Give the shot in a place where you have at least half an inch of fat under the skin. The best areas are the stomach, buttocks, outer thigh, and back of the upper arm. Be sure to rotate to different areas each time you inject. If you do not, you can cause injury and scarring to the tissue and the insulin may not be absorbed. Inject insulin at least 2 inches away from the belly button. Do not give shots near moles or scars. Choose two different places for each shot when taking two shots at one time. Once you have chosen an injection site, clean your skin with an alcohol swab and let it dry before giving the shot. Pick up the syringe like you would hold a pencil and take off the needle cap. Using your other hand, gently pinch the cleaned area into a 3-inch fold. Do not squeeze the skin hard or you might squeeze out the insulin. Insert the needle into your skin at a 90-degree angle if you are using a short needle. Insert the needle into your skin at a 45-degree angle if you are using a long needle. This makes sure you are injecting the insulin into fat instead of muscle. Push the plunger down until all of the insulin is gone from the syringe. Wait 10 seconds, then pull out the needle. Do not take more insulin if any of it leaks out. Just make a note in your insulin and blood sugar log. Do not rub the injection site. This can cause the insulin to be absorbed too fast. For safety, be sure to throw away the syringe after one use. Put it into a container that is either a medical sharps container or one made of extra thick plastic, like one that holds liquid laundry soap. Never reuse or share used syringes with another person. Injecting insulin takes practice. Ask your diabetes educator, nurse, or doctor if you need help or more practice. The information provided in this video is intended to provide educational information only and should not be considered complete medical advice. Always consult your physician and/or healthcare provider for specific medical treatment for you or your child. If you have any questions regarding the information provided in this video, consult your physician and/or healthcare provider. This program, including all images, are the property of Children's Healthcare of Atlanta or third parties. Commercial use by you or anyone authorized by you is prohibited. Any unauthorized use of this program may violate United States copyright laws, trademark laws, laws of privacy and publicity, and communications regulations. The trademarks, logos, and service marks, collectively the trademarks displayed, are registered and unregistered trademarks of Children's Healthcare of Atlanta and others. No trademark displayed may be used without the prior written permission of the owner of such trademarks. Misuse of the trademarks displayed or any other content is strictly prohibited. You are also advised that Children's Healthcare of Atlanta will enforce its rights to the fullest extent of the law.